Dr. Carlo Jeda with DrER.tv. In this video, you're gonna watch what I was getting ready to do, an abscess incision and drainage. And the patient had this nice fluctuant mass. It looked very distended. And by the time I got to there, it was already draining. So I was like, huh, maybe it's gonna drain on its own. So you're gonna see me, this is in the armpit of the patient. You're gonna see me start to touch and it just cleared up. And really, once I got done to washing and irrigating, it left a nice little hole so it can drain out. I washed it off really well, so there was no need to do needles, no need to do scalpel. Again, no need to do cultures because we're gonna assume that this is staph infection. She's already on BACTRIM. We added Caflex for coverage. She's gonna have pain medicine, those kinds of things. So it actually drained on its own. Obviously, if she wouldn't have come, it would have happened, but we were able to irrigate and wash it off because she was better pain control. So I hope you enjoy this one. Bye.
All right, so we're looking at the armpit, arm, torso, and then here. Tell us about this abscess. How long has it been going on? How it developed? You've had them before?
It's something that's reoccurring. I've started feeling pain and developing knots about 5 days ago.
5 days? Mm-hmm.
About 2 days later, it was large, but it was still like hard. Like now it's like it's big, but it's soft.
Mm-hmm.
It's.
You were in the ER.
I was in the ER. I came, but it hadn't. It wasn't nothing that they could lanchet, so it just gave.
At least we thought it was.
We thought it was, right?
It could have been, but we won't know that now.
Right.
We know that now it's ready. I mean, even while you've been here, this is new. It started draining on its own, so it's definitely ready.
And,
if we don't hurry up, the body will do it itself, and then.
But it,
so, any fever, chills, nausea, or vomiting?
No. Just more pain, like,
yeah,
to touch, like, the whole armpit area is being sore.
Mm-hmm. And we've already medicated you with a shot. You said it started working for you, correct?
Correct.
Let me see how much we... Where is it coming from? It seems like coming from... So when we do, it's going to do a field block. We'll actually go kind of underneath and around. But it's, see, right there. It's building pressures already wanted to come out. Oh, it kind of popped on its own.
Oh.
Maybe we won't have to do much.
Oh, what?
So you got
it's already done most of it.
Well.
Let's see. I mean, ideally, you still want to get in there and clean it up. But... Ooh. If you're hurting too much, let me know, but it might save you from the needle and all the lidocaine.
Yes.
It's draining.
I'm just glad it's coming out.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like there's much else there. It's a tiny little bit there. Working it away.
How you doing?
Let me see if I can wash it.
Ooh.
Off.
Pressure.
I mean, first do no harm. If I don't have to get in there and cut you open and stuff, it drained, I can just wash it off and...
That was a smooth, I guess. Was ready to break.
So what I'm doing basically irrigating the inside of it by putting water back in and letting it come back out. It's cleaning it up. It fills back up and back out. In and back out. Do it one more time for sure. Well, that was the easiest one.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's got a nice hole, so even if it continues to drain, it'll have a way out. So yeah, I don't think I have to do much else. Beautiful, beautiful work. Oh, lot of people ask about the core and whether or not we should be removing the core. So what happens is that's creating a scar tissue around it, and this is a hole, right? So eventually it'll heal. It'll stop draining, but the scar tissue will remain. And the likelihood you'll have a recurrence or repeat infections is really high. So unless we actually go in there and take all the scar tissue out, that chance is still there. The problem is when it's actively infected, most doctors don't actually take it out. We treat the infection, give you antibiotics, wait till it heals. And then the surgeon can go, when it's clean, do it in the office. A dermatologist, which is also a medical surgeon, you know, of the skin, they can do that too. But that's, I mean, it's all drained, it's all cleaned up. I mean, there's a little spot right here, fluctuance, but there's no drainage. Very good, very good. Well, that was very easy.
It was.
Much easier than anything I could have done. Let me wash it off a little extra here. This one has a little lidocaine in it. Yeah, it's not coming up. Beautiful. Any questions for us?
Mm-mm.
I mean, it's all done. You did great.
Ooh, I'm glad that it's over.
That was a lot of, what did they call that out?
All right, I have had problems sleeping for years, like tossing and turning, waking up in the night, even falling asleep, like my brain just won't turn off. But I tried this for a month and it works great. I got a full night of sleep, wake up feeling nice and well rested, and now I can finally get to bed on time and have a full night of sleep.
Now you can purchase Rest More. This product helps you get a good night's rest and has been specifically formulated for Dr. Carlo Aller. This dietary supplement combines tryptophan, melatonin, and valeria to ensure you quickly and safely enter deep sleep without feeling groggy the next day. It is particularly effective for people with rotating shifts and people with jet lag, as the melatonin helps reset your body's clock and normal sleep cycles. Available now using the eBay link in the description of the video and soon on the Amazon store.